Kubor nagashlem jung unong san hima.
Menteri Ketenat Forest and Environment Kasurkar Jela U James K. Sangma Walahiar Bantua Jingmut Naginong Elam Shnong Maru Nakiri Rangba Jongki Katra Tliki Shnong Hamau Lendep Hakani Kajingya Kendu Lai Shim Bentalang Dagi Rangba Shnong Jongki Shnong Mau Lendep Umraleng Maulang Nongkrem Sany Urbania Mau Tenen Nong Tuar Sau Sopping Wakskun Pataran Pung Wak Pipa Bangla Lau Huleng Mau Korblang Nong Tuar Se Nyang Dai Bat Terkang Kani ka project ka Deishi Benda Jong ke Jing Sedang Ben Pendek Pensa Ya Kamariang Da Ka Ba Ai Jing Hikai Nadu Tenrai Haba Ya Dei Ben Ke Jing Pendek Ya Kamei Mariang Na Kaliang Ujim Sang Ma Aula Ong Ba Ke Jing Senjar Kan Trai Kamha Lada Kipaj Ba Kia Shim Bentalang Kejelami khalaya ke donya ke jintip, ialah ke jong ke jat benriu, ba ke long ke bat kentang, bat ke baru yuspa, habai day berkejing itenat jong ke mei mariang. Na kaliang ujim sangma ula ajing muru, bandono da ke Joint Forest Management Committee, ke bandon haman laki senong, ha ke jing itreilang, bat ke surkar jela. Kenang makin lah ban pendek pensa, ya ke jing itenat jong ke mei mariang.
I'm trying my best, you know, to make sure that MSCL becomes a better organization, but it's very difficult, you know. So for too long, you know, things have been going on this way. Now I'm trying to change. So hopefully we will change. Number two is that I will be making all BPL connections free. Okay. Yeah. So we have not declared it yet, but very soon I'll be declaring that all BPL connections will be free. So in all consumers who are below 200 units, you know, we will make them all free. Thirdly, you know, problem like this, we know that, you know, this will always happen if there is a meter reader. A meter reader will go to the house and he will see the meter. He will take note of the meter, the reading of the thing, and then take it back, prepare bill, serve user. So it's a very long process. And sometimes meter readers, they are sometimes not all, but they're lazy. So they don't go to a house also. So they will just sit in some place and say, ha, his bill, let us say he's consumed 500 units this month. So he'll just make a rough bill. And then the bill is also not given to you in time. So then, you know, it becomes very difficult because you can pay your bill for 1 month, 2 months. But then when that becomes 5 months, 6 months, then big burden on everybody because you know the bill becomes very big. So for that we wanted to bring in smart meters. So a lot of people don't know about smart meters, what they are. Na? So smart meter is a meter, smart meter which is also prepaid. So like you have mobile phone in which you have prepaid. So like that, electricity also we are going to start this prepaid system for consumers. So for this month, you say that, you know, I go to a shop, I buy a scratch card, and then I put that number into my meter, so you'll be able to, you know, pay in advance. So there's no question of your, wrong billing, number one, and number two, of late billing. So you will not have that problem anymore. So many people don't know what smart meter is, but I think it's important that we explain this to people everywhere because we're going to bring it. And this is no cost. People say that consumer, that means you have to pay for it. No. Government is paying for it. We will install it and then you can use it as a prepaid meter also. So I think that when we have all these things, all the consumers who are there, especially BPL, it will be very, very beneficial for all of you. Number one, I will make it free. Number two, those who use more than 200 units, they can use in a prepaid.
Now, only once a year that you're being able to, grow your agricultural products and harvest it. It is affecting the livelihood, and it's very unfortunate, but you know that this is something that all of us are living with right now. But the problem The bigger problem is, as you all know, something called climate change. And climate change is affecting the entire planet. It's affecting everyone. And I think it's everyone's duty, including you and me and the future generation. We have to teach them, we have to sensitize them about the reality that climate change is. It is very real. Many people say that it is nothing, but it is very real. As you have seen, there's no less rainfall. As you can see nowadays, there the temperature has gone up. So what happens is that even 1 degree of temperature difference, say suppose you've been living in this really nice place where, you know, you've never had to use fans, you've never had to, use AC. And in such a place where you have 1 degree of change in temperature also, it affects the plant species, you know. It affects agricultural production, even a 1 degree difference. So a lot of people may say climate change is nothing serious, but it is affecting everyone. And today in Garo Hills, for example, we have hailstorm, and it is so unpredictable. So every March, April, there's hailstorms, and then it destroys crops. We have thunderstorms, which these are like cyclones, which come and blow away the rooftops of houses and destroy crops also. So all these things are happening, and it is a reality. But many people still think that, you know, it's nothing, because it's slowly that that effect takes place.
So I'm very happy to be here at Mollendeb Village at the invitation of the Kum Ying Day. This is a group of the Rangpashnongs of 18 villages which are around, in and around Mollendeb. And it's been a really great interaction that I've had with the Rangpashnongs, the secretaries and leaders of these 18 villages today. There are many points that the leaders have mentioned in the due course of my interaction today with them, and these are regarding livelihood issues, regarding infrastructure issues of the village, and also I have had a chance to discuss many other important issues like the environment, especially in relation to climate change, and also regarding the COVID-19 situation. And this has been a great enlightening and very insightful experience for me to have interacted, wherein many points have come up as even as suggestions by the leaders of these villages, by the Rangpashnongs and secretaries. And today I'd like to lay stress on the discussion on climate change and on the environment. It's really heartening to see that there is so much awareness among the people of this village and the surrounding village when it comes to issues relating to the environment and issues relating to climate change. The awareness is there about the kind of ill effects of certain activities which are taking place here, but the helplessness is something that really touches me, because of lack of infrastructure. Many of these villages are left with no choice but to go for environmentally harmful activities like felling of trees for charcoal and other things like that.